Hi, welcome to another Macworld video. I'm your host, Senior Editor Chris Breen. You know, I have a lot of my media on my laptop and my desktop computers, but what I really like is to be able to access that content on something like my iPhone or iPod Touch. Problem is, not a lot of storage here. So what do? That's the point of this video. Streaming content from your desktop computer to something like an iPod or an iPhone. Let's start with audio.
Simplify Media makes the process, well, simple. Just install the application and create a screen name and password. And upload a list of all the unprotected music in your iTunes library or within your music folder. Unfortunately, protected music isn't compatible, nor are videos. A large library list takes about 5 minutes to upload. Now purchase the $4 Simplify Media iPhone application from the App Store and install it on your iPhone or iPod Touch. In that application, enter the screen name and password for your Simplify account. The application will take a couple of minutes to update the playlists and, when connected to a network, let you stream music from your library to your iPhone or iPod Touch. The interface is similar to what you find in the iPod section of an iPhone. Here you'll find entries for all the library's albums, artists, genres, and songs, as well as the library's playlists if you've configured it to include them. On the Now Playing screen, you'll find a Song tab where you can view a track's title, artist, album, year of release, and, if available, album art. Tap Artist and you'll see a short biography of the artist. And tap Lyrics to display, if available, the track's lyrics. Within the Simplify Media application on your computer, you can invite up to 30 friends to listen to your iTunes library. They'll need a Simplify Media account, but once they have it, just click the Invite button and they'll see your invitation. Once they accept it, they can listen to your music. Simplify Media also works within iTunes. When you've accepted an invitation, the music library you've accepted the invitation to appears under the shared heading in iTunes. Just select it and play what you like. One final note, Simplify can be a processor hog on all but the speediest Macs. When sharing music, don't be surprised if your Mac slows down.
Okay, so now we've got audio covered. What about video? Here's an option.
That option is Roxio's Streamer, an application included with Roxio's $80 Toast Titanium 9. The idea is this. You launch Streamer and create a free Streamer account with Roxio. Drag compatible, meaning unprotected, video files into its window. Toast will launch and convert these files to a streamer-friendly format. That format is H.264 at 320 by 180, 24 frames per second mono audio. In short, the files are made tiny enough that they'll stream evenly over a Wi-Fi network. When complete, it adds these files to your user's document folder and the streamer window. Turn on Streamer and its files are now available via any web browser. A link to your Streamer library is found at the bottom of the Streamer window. Fire up your web browser, enter your password, click the Login button, and you'll see a screen that contains all the videos you've added to Streamer. On a computer, you click on the video you want to watch, and QuickTime Player opens and starts streaming the movie. On your iPhone or iPod Touch, just launch Mobile Safari, enter the URL, log in with your password, and tap on the video you want to watch. Before too long, the video starts playing in either portrait or landscape mode. On an iPhone or iPod Touch, video will look a little soft. On the other hand, this is a minor miracle that you can do this at all, so given that, it's pretty nice.
And there you have it, two ways to stream media from your computer to a device such as an iPhone or an iPod Touch. I hope you found it helpful. Thanks for joining me. See you around.